morning to all of you. The other day we have learnt about the perfect square numbers and their square roots, and non-perfect square numbers and examples for them. Okay, but in today's session we will learn about what are perfect cubes and their cube roots, and what are non-perfect cubes and examples for them. Okay, let us start the today's session.
Okay children, before we learn about perfect cube numbers and their cube roots, let us recapitulate what are perfect square numbers and their square roots. Any number which can be written or expressed as the product of two equal integral factors is called a perfect square number. A perfect square number can be a product of two equal positive integral factors or two equal negative integral factors. And any number which is multiplied twice to get the perfect square number is called its square root. And we have learnt all these things in the previous classes. Perfect square numbers and their square roots are as given below. One is a perfect square because 1 is equal to plus 1 into plus 1 or minus 1 into minus 1. Therefore, 1 is a product of two equal integral factors. But to get 1, which numbers are multiplied twice? Plus 1 is multiplied twice or minus 1 is multiplied twice. Therefore, the square root of 1 is equal to plus or minus 1. 4 is a perfect square number because 4 is equal to plus 2 into plus 2 or minus 2 into minus 2. To get 4, which numbers are multiplied twice? Plus 2 is multiplied twice or minus 2 is multiplied twice. That is why the square root of 4 is equal to plus or minus 2. Similarly, 9 is a perfect square and the square root of 9 is plus or minus 3. 16 is a perfect square and its square root is plus or minus 4. 25 is a perfect square because 25 is equal to plus 5 into plus 5 or minus 5 into minus 5. Therefore, 25 is the product of two equal positive integral factors or two equal negative integral factors. And to get 25, plus 5 is multiplied twice or minus 5 is multiplied twice. That is why the square root of 25 is plus 5 or minus 5. Similarly, 36 is a perfect square and the square root of 36 is plus or minus 6. 49 is a perfect square and the square root of 49 is plus or minus 7. 64 is a perfect square because 64 is equal to plus 8 into plus 8 or minus 8 into minus 8. Therefore, 64 is the product of two equal positive integral factors or negative integral factors or integral numbers. Okay. And the square root of 64 is plus 8 or minus 8, because if we multiply plus 8 two times, we get the number 64. And if we multiply minus 8 two times, we get the perfect square number 64. This is all about the recapitulation of the meaning of perfect square numbers and their square roots. In today's session, we will learn about the perfect cube numbers and their cube roots. And after that, we will learn about the non-perfect cubes. Okay?
Okay, children. Now let us learn about one more type of numbers called perfect cube numbers. Okay? If you have studied about perfect square numbers and their square roots, then it will become easier for us to learn and study about perfect cube numbers and their cube roots. Okay? According to the definition, what is a perfect cube number? Okay? It is a number which is expressed or written as the product of three equal integral numbers or three equal integral factors. Okay? Such number is called a perfect cube number. For example, 1. 1 is a perfect cube number because 1 can be written as the product of three equal integral numbers. What are those? 1, 1, 1. If you multiply these three ones, okay, or 1 three times, you will get the number 1 as the product. Therefore, 1 is a perfect cube number. Okay, see here, plus 1 into plus 1 into plus 1. Okay, plus into plus is plus, plus into plus is plus, therefore plus. 1 ones are 1, 1 ones are 1, therefore it is equal to plus 1. But this 1 is not written as the product of minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. Here minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 are the three equal factors. But if you multiply these three, you will not get plus 1. That is why 1 is equal to only 1 into 1 into 1. That is why 1 is equal to plus 1 into plus 1 into plus 1. But not minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. Do you know why? Minus into minus is plus. Plus into minus is minus. Okay? But we want plus here. 1 ones are 1, 1 ones are 1. Therefore minus 1. Can plus 1 be equal to minus 1? No. That is why a perfect cube number is expressed as the product of 3 positive integral factors. Not as the product of 3 negative integral factors. Let me take one more example. 8. 8 is a perfect cube number because 8 is the product of 3 equal integral factors. Which factors? Positive factors. How? Here 2, 2, 2 are the 3 equal factors and you are multiplying them. After multiplication, whatever the answer you get is called product. Therefore here 8 is the product of the multiplication of these three equal factors or equal integral numbers. Okay. First we multiply the sign. Plus into plus is plus. Plus into plus is plus. And it is plus. 2 twos are 4. 4 twos are 8. It is plus 8. Right. Therefore here 8 is equal to the product of plus 2 into plus 2 into plus 2. But 8 is not equal to the product of minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2. Shall we check? Minus into minus is plus. Plus into minus is minus. 2 twos are 4, 4 twos are 8. Is plus 8 equal to minus 8? No. That is why 8 is equal to the product of 3 positive integral factors, but 8 is not equal to the product of 3 negative integral factors. Okay? Similarly, children, 27. 27 is also a perfect cube number. Do you know why? Because 27 is the product of 3 equal integral factors. Positive integral factors, which are those plus 3 and plus 3 and plus 3. Okay, here plus into plus is plus, plus into plus is plus, therefore plus. 3 threes are 9, 9 threes are 27, therefore plus 27 is equal to plus 27. Okay, therefore 27 is the product of 3 equal integral factors. That is why 27 is a perfect cube, but 27 is not equal to minus 3 into minus 3 into minus 3. Okay. Similarly, 125 is also a perfect cube number since it can be expressed as the product of 3 equal integral factors. 3 positive equal integral factors. Okay. See here, plus 5 into plus 5 into plus 5. 5 5s are 25, 25 5s are 125. And plus into plus is plus, plus into plus is again plus. Thus, 125 is equal to 125. But 125 is not equal to minus 5 into minus 5 into minus 5. But 125 is a perfect cube. So children, here we learn that in general, if n is a perfect cube number, okay,
then n is written as n is equal to plus a into plus a into plus a, where a are equal integral factors, positive equal integral factors. How many? 3 equal integral factors. Okay, therefore n is equal to the product of 3 equal integral factors. Okay, but n is not equal to the product of 3 negative integral factors. Okay, so children, we learnt about the perfect cube numbers. It is a number which is expressed or written as a product of 3 equal integral numbers or 3 equal integral factors. Okay, now let us learn about what are non-perfect cubes. Okay, non-perfect cubes are also numbers. You cannot write them as the product of 3 equal integral factors. Okay, here 12 is equal to the product of 3 factors. Which are those 3 factors? 2, 2 and 3. But are they all equal? They are not equal. Here 2, 2 are same, but 3 is different. That is why 12 is not equal to the product of 3 equal integral factors. That is why 12 is a non-perfect cube. Similarly, take 18. 18 is equal to 2 into 3 into 3. So, the product of 2, 3, 3 gives 18. How? 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18. 18 is the product of these 3 integral numbers or integral factors. But are they equal? No, they are not equal. So, 18 is equal to the product of 3 different factors or different integral factors. That is why 18 is not a perfect cube. And similarly, 54 is also not a perfect cube. Okay, but 54 is equal to the product of 3 factors. What type of factors? Unequal factors. That is why 54 is not a perfect cube. Therefore, children, what do we mean by a perfect cube number? It is a number that cannot be written or expressed as the product of 3 equal integral factors or equal integral numbers. Okay, so if n is a non-perfect cube, then n is not equal to plus a into plus a into plus a. Okay, so we learnt about the definition of perfect cube numbers and non-perfect cube numbers and examples for that. Okay, children? Now let us study about the cube roots of perfect cube numbers. Okay? If you have the knowledge of perfect square and square roots, then the things become easier here to understand the meaning of cube roots. Okay? But remember, only perfect cube numbers will have cube roots. Okay? Perfect square numbers will have square roots and perfect cube numbers will have cube roots. Okay? This is the symbol of cube root. Okay? This is read as cube. 3 means cube and this is the root mark. Okay? Therefore, this is the symbol of cube root. Okay? Let us understand what do we mean by cube root. Okay, see here children, now let us take an example. 8. 8 is equal to the product of 3 equal factors. Okay, therefore 8 is a perfect cube. According to the definition of perfect cube is a number that is written as the product of 3 equal factors. Here 8 is equal to the product of 3 equal factors. Okay, 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, plus into plus is plus, that plus into plus is plus. Therefore, 8 is the product of 3 positive equal integral factors. Therefore, 8 is a perfect cube. See here, 8 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2, right? But 2 into 2 into 2 is written as 2 cube. Therefore, 8 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 is also written as 8 is equal to 2 cube or 2 raised to the power of 3, or we can read it as 2 cube. Okay? Hence, 8 is a perfect cube here. My question is, to get this 8, which number is multiplied 3 times? That number is called cube root of 8. Okay? So, children, to get 8, which number is multiplied 3 times? Plus 2 is multiplied 3 times. Plus 2 is multiplied 3 times. That is why this plus 2 is called the cube root of 8. Okay. In statement form we write the cube root of 8 is plus 2. Okay. And symbolically we write it as cube root of 8 is equal to plus 2. Children, before any number if there is no sign, you should understand that there is plus sign. Okay. So, plus 2. Right? Therefore, the statement is the cube root of 8 is 2. Right? But symbolically, we write it as cube root of 8 is equal to plus 2. Okay? Before any number, if there is no sign, you should understand there is plus. Therefore, we can write plus or we may not. But before any number, if there is minus sign, we must have to compulsorily or mandatorily mention. Okay? Therefore, children, it is read as cube root of 8 is equal to plus 2 or simply 2. But see here, children, 8 is equal to 2 cube. Therefore, instead of 8, I can write 2 cube here. Therefore, cube root, thus it is cube root of 8. Instead of 8, I can write 2 cube. Thus, cube root of 8 is equal to plus 2 or cube root of 2 cube is equal to plus 2. You should think that if this is called order of the root. If this number and this number are same, you cancel these two and write this 2 here. Or the whatever the number is present here. Right? That is cube root. Okay? Let us take one more example here. 216 is equal to the product of 3 equal integral factors. What are those 3 equal integral factors? Plus 6, plus 6, plus 6. If we multiply all these 3 positive integral factors, you will get 216 as the product. Therefore, 216 is a perfect cube, right? But children, here 6 into 6 into 6 can be written as 6 cube or 6 raised to the power of 3. How? Here 6 6 are 36, 36 6 are 216, right? But 6 into 6 into 6 is 6 cube. Okay? If here it is x into x into x, what we write? X cube. Therefore, 6 into 6 into 6 is written as 6 cube. So, 216 is equal to 6 into 6 into 6 is same as 216 is equal to 6 cube. Right? My question is, to get this perfect cube 216, which number is multiplied 3 times? Okay? Or which number is cubed? That number is called the cube root of the given perfect cube number. Okay? Therefore, children, we can write, to get this 216, 6 is multiplied 3 times. That is why we write the cube root of 216 is 6. Which 6? Plus 6. Okay? And symbolically, it is written as cube root of 216 is equal to 6. Okay? And here 216 is also equal to 6 cube. Therefore, instead of 216, if I put 6 cube here, it becomes like this. Cube root of 6 cube is equal to 6. Here, this number and this number, if they are same, you can cancel them and this 6 comes out. Okay? This is how cube root of 6 cube is equal to 6 is same as cube root of 216 is equal to 6. Okay, let us take one more example and finish. 512 is a number. It is the product of 3 equal integral factors. Which are those? 8, 8, 8. Which 8? Plus 8, plus 8, plus 8. Okay, plus into plus is plus, plus into plus is plus. 8 8s are 64 and 64 8s are 512. Okay? Therefore, I can express or I can write
512 as the product of three equal integral factors, positive integral factors and positive equal integral factors. Positive three equal integral factors. So 512 is a perfect cube. Here 512 is equal to 8 into 8 into 8. Right? Therefore I can write 512 is equal to 8 cube, because it is equal to 8 into 8 into 8. 8 into 8 into 8 is 8 cube. That is why I write 8 cube. So 512 is equal to 8 into 8 into 8 is also equal to 512 is equal to 8 cube. Right? And so children, to get this 512, which number is multiplied 3 times? The number plus 8 is multiplied 3 times. That is why this plus 8 is called the cube root of 512. On the other hand, to get this 512, which number is cubed? The number 8 is cubed. Okay? That is why the number plus 8 is called the cube root of 512. And statement form, we write it as the cube root of 512 is 8. Right? And symbolically, we write it as cube root of 512 is equal to 8. Okay? Cube root of 512 is equal to 8. This is symbolical form and this is statement form. But children, 512 is 8 cube. Therefore, instead of 512, I can write 8 cube here. Thus, cube root of 8 cube is also equal to 8. Which 8? Plus 8. Right? Before any number, if there is no sign, you can put plus. Okay? It can be simply cube root of 8 cube is equal to 8 or plus 8. Both are same. Is it clear to you, children? So children, this is all about the perfect cubes and their cube roots. Okay? In general, if a is a positive integer, then we have square root of a is equal to, simply I can remove this 2 and write as root a, and it is read as square root of a. Okay? It is read as cube root of a. It is written as cube root of a. So children, we learnt about the perfect cubes and cube roots. In general, if a belongs to a positive integer z plus, then we have the following. That is, symbolically it is written like this, square root of a. Symbolically, it is written as square root of a. It is also equal to root a. If we write this 2, or if we do not write also, you should think that there is 2. This is called order of the root. It is read as square root of a. If we write like this, how should we read it? Square root of a. If we write like this, symbolically, it is cube root of a. Okay? Cube root of a, and it is read as cube root of a. Right? See here, I have written 4 here. This is read as, you know, 4th root of a. Okay? Is equal to what? 4th root of a. It is symbolically and read as 4th root of a. Okay? And here, the order of the root is 4. Right? Look at this, children. This is read as nth root of a. What is it? Symbolically, we write it like this. And how should it be read? Nth root mark a, and is read as nth root of a. Okay? This is square root of a, and this is read as cube root of a, and this is read as fourth root of a, and this is read as nth root of a. Okay? If here there is 2, you should mean that this number should be expressed as the product of 2 equal factors. If here it is 3, you should note that
this A should be the product of three equal factors. If here there is 4, you should know that the inside number A should be product of 4 equal factors. Okay? And if here there is N, you should know that the number A should be written as the product of A, how many times? N number of times. Okay? So children, in today's session, we learnt about what are perfect cubes and non-perfect cubes and how to find the cube root of the given number, or what is the meaning of the cube root of the given number. Please note down these points in your mind, children.
Here 64 is equal to 8 into 8, or 64 is equal to 8 square, because 8 into 8 is equal to 8 square. Therefore, 64 is equal to 8 square, or 8 square is equal to 64. 225 is equal to 15 into 15. Okay? But 15 into 15 is 15 square. That is why 225 is equal to 15 square, or 15 square is equal to 225. 8 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2. Therefore, 2 into 2 into 2 is 2 cube. That is why, children, 8 is equal to 2 cube, or 2 cube is equal to 8. 216 is equal to 6 into 6 into 6. Here, 6 into 6 into 6 is 6 cube. That is why 216 is equal to 6 cube, or 6 cube is equal to 216. 512 is equal to 8 into 8 into 8. Therefore, 8 into 8 into 8 is 8 cube. 8 into 8 into 8 is 8 cube. Therefore, 512 is equal to 8 cube, or 8 cube is equal to 512. Okay? With this concept, I would like to close my today's session and see you tomorrow with some other concept. Till then, goodbye.